I have so many experiences that I can draw from. I recall that I was communicating with the company that we were going to do business with for months, and our communication was cordial. We had no issues throughout. And there was a time when we had to have a face-to-face meeting, and when I turned up, the boss in charge said out loud, "Oh, this company is owned by a black person?" And it took me off guard. All this kind of discrimination has happened for centuries. It's not new. And unless we take a very systematic approach to combating it, it's not going to stop. We'll still be having this conversation 20, 30, 50 years from now if you don't take a stand. Just like how we've taken a stand against how to resolve COVID, right? We can see racism as another pandemic, which has been around longer than COVID. And we need to systematically work against stopping that. So the city is doing that. I think that there needs to be greater partnership between the city of Pickering, meaning the leadership of the city of Pickering, and our residents. There are lots of organizations that are involved in anti-Black racism advocacy, but there needs to be a bridging. There needs to be partnership between those groups and those in leadership positions.
And we've engaged in many conversations over the last weeks and months to try and elicit that information, and we'll continue to do so. And those conversations often are very, very difficult because it forces us to confront those real issues of racism, of privilege, and of the systemic base for the problem that obviously exists within our community. And it's through those conversations that we are going to address them. But I think it's important for all of us to recognize that this isn't something that is going to change overnight. It's not something that can change overnight. But we can, beginning today and going forward, make an honest effort and be honest with ourselves about what the problems are and our role in that problem as we move forward together.
Situations where, you know, I've been physically approached, called the N-word, you know, been like pushed and accused of things. And yeah, you know, it was definitely a little switch from the norm, and it wasn't cool.
I've had experiences where people look and they say, you know, "Oh, I didn't realize you were black," when I enter a meeting room or when I'm speaking on the phone and I show up in person. Or people who say, "You're very articulate," whatever that means. It seems to be a favorite thing that I've heard. I've lived here and in the United States, and I hear it a lot in Canada.
I wouldn't want my daughter to have to deal with anything like that, although I know she probably is. Being a woman and also being black, it's a lot, you know? So a lot of this initiative is to do as much as we can and steer it in the right direction. Hopefully kids like my daughter, or your kids, or anybody else's kids don't have to go through the things that we had to go through.